Well, I think it's okay. So, my ladies and gentlemen, attendees, participants of this conference, we have a nice people coming from Europe also, Enrique. We miss you very much. This is my Enrique Herrera. He is the wonderful person and also a big scientist, have highly citations, highly cited researcher, and also he employed now as a vice president of University of Granada for research. And this is for 5 years already. He had a lot of work, and I think you can see his CV on the conference website. And usually I would like to him be here with us because he's not only friend, more than friend, more than brother. And he's also a colleague of me for science. We have been working for long years, and he'd been here in this city, in Kokura before, another conference. We did it in 2017. We enjoy it very much. Enrique, the microphone is for you, and okay. You can talk whenever you want, even the stories of Andalusia.
Thank you, Hamidou. Thank you for your nice presentation. Is possible for you to see my slide? Yes, my presentation is okay.
Super, super. I see you. I see you and see the slide as beside me. So everything is fine.
Thank you, Hamidou. Okay. Thank you. You, Sasaki, all people that stay with me this morning. Sorry very much not to stay in Japan. In the past, many years ago, 3 years ago, I remember that I was the opportunity to visit this nice city. I hope to start with you the time in the future. But now it's not the problem to the COVID, it's the problem of my agenda because I had a lot of activities now in Granada. For me, it's more complicated to travel. But okay, online is possible to start with you this time. Of course, I open my collaboration, that is possible to obtain my collaboration by internet, by online. You had any question, no, now, for the future, for me, no problem to share with you my idea and my collaboration, even to stay to Granada to visit me. Okay, today I want to spend the time in order to show you different aspects about to the facial linguistic decision making, different scenario that is interesting to work, and the more important for you is to identify the challenges in order to open new idea, new research in this specific topic relative to the facial decision making. In my curriculum, I had a lot of different topics to speak, but now I address different new scenario in facial decision making. And now we had with me in Granada a lot of people from many countries working this topic in the different address. People from China, people from Norway, from Latin America, for USA are collaborating with me. It's true that sometimes we're working from the theoretical point of view, but then if you know a very specific problem, a very particular problem, it's possible to translate this kind of the theoretical model to the real problem. This is the goal, really. But okay, these stories, in order to open your mind to many different ideas that is possible to study for the future. And this is my goal that I say you in this topic. Firstly, I want to provide you the different motivation about the importance of these topics. You know that decision making is the cognitive process in order to select the best alternative. Sometimes you select many alternatives from the multiple different alternatives. Normally, the decision making is the rational, sometimes rational process. Normally, in order to make decision, you need to use information, and the people use the explicit assumption, or sometimes the people use the tacit assumption, depending on the situation. But it's clear for us that decision making is the user activity in our life. Every day, you make a lot of decision making in your usual activity. For example, for shopping, for design. What to eat, for design who or what to buy for a special election or referendum. Sometimes we are working in order to develop different automatic systems in order to help to the people, in order to make the best decision in the particular framework. This is the goal of the decision-making system, really. We identify different environment of decision making in order to distinguish the type of the alternative knowledge assessment that you had about to the alternative. For example, you identify three important environments. Certainty environment, if you had knowledge assessment on the alternative, is clearly known. Sometimes we are working the risk environment, when you had the knowledge of the alternative is probabilistic, the knowledge that you had of the alternative is probabilistic. The focus of my talk, when you work in the uncertainty environment, in this case, the knowledge of the assessment on the alternative are evaluated in an approximative fashion, and no using probabilistic information. In this case, the people say that people assume that you're using fuzzy information. And you identify the situation of the decision making as the name of the fuzzy decision making. Fuzzy decision making is defined when you had information about the alternative that is expressive but in a vague and imprecise way. Normally, such susceptibility in the expert opinion can be represented by means of the very popular concept in our decision making theory, the fuzzy set. In the different approach, it's possible to identify two ways to represent the fuzzy set in decision making, using the quantitative information and using the linguistic level, the qualitative information. In both cases, the father of this theory, the father of this area was the professor Lotizade, very popular, very famous researcher in our community. And they proposed the base of the both case of the fuzzy decision making model in the different paper that we share with you in this slide. My idea today is, the goal today is to analyze the different aspects related to the fuzzy and linguistic decision-making model that I say you was introduced by Professor Lotizade. And to share with you what is the main important trends, study, methodologies, and model that the people provides in the literature of the very important journal in the last 15 years. Okay, this is the outline of my presentation. Firstly, we identify what is the most important information representation format that the people use to provide to represent the expert opinion. Then we identify, we show you what is the more important decision-making framework that the people use to provide the model to solve the problems and to provide the different theoretical model that is possible to identify in the literature. And the third part of my presentation is the more important is to identify what is the challenge in decision making guided by the wisdom of the cross. Okay. And finally, we present my conclusion. This is the traditional approach that we had in decision making, that we consider different formats to represent the expert opinion. Normally we had a problem to solve, we had the different alternative that's is possible different option to solve this problem. We have the set of the expert, the group of experts that provide the opinion about to this alternative. Normally inside to this set of experts, we identify the special person called moderator. They control the decision-making process. They receive the opinion and they sometimes they provide to the expert different recommendations in order to close the opinion, in order to achieve the consensus solution. During different decision round, the people discuss, at the end, the people obtain the solution alternative. This is the traditional decision-making content that we use in the fuzzy decision-making. And the more important here is how it's possible to introduce the different freedom degrees to express the expert opinion, okay? And we identify six different information representation format that the people use in order to introduce in the representation of the expert opinion, this freedom degree. The most popular is to use fuzzy number assessment. The idea here is to use the traditional concept of the fuzzy set, in this case called fuzzy number, instead of the provide for every alternative an exact value. For example, the people use expression like about 0.6 in order to indicate a number, a real number, in a vague but practical way. At the end, the people provide the fuzzy number, the fuzzy set, to represent the expert opinion, and they don't use the particular number to express your opinion. This is the first approach that the Professor Lotizades provide to the community in order to design the fuzzy decision making. From this first information representation format, we had different opportunity to extend the concept. One important possibility is, for example, in order to represent the membership degree, the people don't use the particular number. The people decide to use the special interval value number inside to the unit interval. The representation in this case is more complicated, but it's possible to do. It's very popular to do. This representation is called interval value fuzzy set. Okay. Remember, the important is that people here not provide the particular membership degree for every alternative. In this case, the people provide the interval value number close inside to the unit interval, a collection of the lab. Other very popular information representation format is the ATASANO intuitive fuzzy assessment. In this case, for every alternative, the people provide different degree, the membership degree and the non-membership degree. This is a combination of the both concept. It's very popular. Even different authors have demonstrated that the previous information representation format is equivalent to this intuitive fuzzy assessment. Okay, it's very popular. It's very useful in many, many different decision-making problems. ATASANO is the father of this idea, Professor ATASANO. The four important information representation format that we identify is the use of the hesitant fuzzy assessment. In this case, the Professor Vicentorra introduced a new extension of the fuzzy set in order to represent the expert opinion called hesitant fuzzy set. The idea here is very easy. For every alternative, you don't provide only the membership degree, one membership degree. You provide several membership degrees for every alternative, a collection, in order to identify what is the preference of the particular value, for example. But you provide a collection, the particular membership degree. This is the idea. The very popular information representation format is to use the linguistic assessment. Remember that at the beginning I say that we had two different fuzzy decision making models. One model uses numerical values, another model uses linguistic values. Okay, this is the case. The idea here is when the expert provides the assessment using words rather than real numbers. We identify this technology with the name of the computer Google. It's very popular. It's a way to approximate the traditional way to express the opinion by the expert, that normally the people use linguistic expression. And this is a way to represent this linguistic expression. This is very popular. In order to design this kind of the fuzzy decision making model using linguistic information, we need to identify and to define different methodology in which the main computational element, instead of the fuzzy number, instead of the number, are linguistic variable, whose values are proportion and words drawn from the natural language. But really, what you investigate the different linguistic approach, you observe that inside to the model, at the end, we use the mathematical expression. We don't use natural language. In this way, this possibility, the focus of this possibility is not to use natural language. It's a way to represent the world, but it's not natural language. It's a way to approximate. In order to do that, we use the very popular concept that Professor Zada introduced many years ago, the concept of the linguistic variable. The more important here is to identify the syntactic rules in order to produce different labels to express the opinion. And one important aspect is to identify the semantic rules in order to associate to every linguistic label the particular meaning. Because at the end, I say you, it's a way to represent the natural language, but not is natural language, but you represent it by means of the mathematical expression. This is my focus really, because many years ago we developed a lot of different way to manage the linguistic information in the decision making models. We spent a lot of time. We developed a lot of different approaches. You can to study my proposal in my webpage. We identified from the general point of view different models in order to control the computing we work, in order to manage the computing we work. many authors use fuzzy number. This is the traditional way. This is the traditional way that proposed the Professor Zade. Other authors use ordinal qualitative scale. This is my case, even the case of the very popular Professor Ronald Jager introduced this idea. In the last year, other people introduced different techniques in order to manage the linguistic level. For example, the use of the linguistic scale function. Finally, in the last year, we identified new information representation format that the people use in order to represent the assessment. In this case, the possibility to use complex linguistic assessment. In the previous one, the people represent the opinion using the particular level, not too much. The idea here is the possibility to use not only one level, to use to represent the particular preference with the different levels. Okay. In this case, we have different extension of the previous model that the people use. For example, we have the hesitant fuzzy linguistic tense set that the people provide the technology to manage the complex linguistic assessment using the concept of the hesitant fuzzy number. Okay. Other idea that people provide is to use the linguistic distribution in order to manage this complex linguistic assessment. Now, many people are spending a lot of time in order to develop this kind of the technology to manage the linguistic information. Okay, now I want to share with you what is the more important decision-making framework that the people use in order to develop this kind of the linguistic and fuzzy decision-making. We identify the problem and the model. From the general point of view, we identify three different framework in order to establish the different fuzzy decision-making. The first is when you, it's called multi-criterial decision-making. You have different criteria in order to express the assessment about to the particular alternative. The second is when you had the framework, the group decision making, you had a lot of people working together in order to look for the solution to the particular problem. The previous one scan that characterized this process. And the third framework, when you combine both, you had a group of the expert that want to work together in order to make decision, but they need to satisfy different restriction, different criteria in order to make this decision. It's a combination of the both aspects, set of aspects and set of the criteria. In the multi-criterial decision making, is formally characterized by means of the, you consider a finished set of the alternative, you consider a finished set of the criteria, every criteria normally has associated an important weight. The important way establish different relevance degree among the criteria. Okay. Normally, in this case, the criteria weights are usually normalized. Okay. This is the traditional. In this case, on the context, normally the people use evaluation matrix in order to provide the preference among the alternative. The idea here is that you compare every alternative with respect to the other alternative in the particular criteria. In this case, you have a lot of matrix. One matrix for every criteria. Okay, in this topic, in this context, we identify different very popular models that we have to deal with this problem. When the people decide to express the opinion of the expert by means of the utility value, this is the case of the value measuring. In this case, we need to develop the important aggregation operator in order to find the solution. This is important. Even in this case, when you use the utility value, you need to normalize into the unit assessment representation scale, because sometimes the people use different scale and you need to normalize the problem. In the table, we start with you different reference to the very important model that the people provide. In the case, for example, the simple additive weighting is one model. In the first case, we identify the weighted aggregated sound product assessment. But in this case, it's very important to design the appropriate aggregation operator. In particular, if you use weights associated to every criteria, you need to define very interesting, very useful weighting aggregator operator. My recommendation for you is, for example, to read different papers from the Professor Ronald Jager. He is an expert in the design of the aggregation operator. He provides different tools in order to develop normal aggregation operation and weighted aggregation operation. More sophisticated, but necessary in order to combine the information with the weight. The other different model that we identify when the people provide the opinion, with the referent using the distance MISI to the referent level. Okay. In this case, the idea is to find the alternative that is close to the ideal solution. Or farthest from the negative ideal solution. You establish the referent level and the people provide the opinion using this referent level. Here is very important to define the appropriate distance mission because it's the key computational process in the extension, in the fuzzy extension of this model. Here we identify a very popular model called TOSIS, for example, or BICO. It's very, very, very popular. Here is the fundamental of the many, many traditional European decision-making model. We identify a lot of people in Europe working in this model. Other possibility is that the people provide the opinion using the binarian matrix. This is the name or we identify this case when the people use outranking. In this case, they don't not require normally say no unified assessment because they provide information by me of the binary values, one or zero. More important here is that the comparison is the key computational process in the fuzzy linguistic decision making. Here, in this case, we identify a lot of very popular decision making models, for example, Prometheus or Este or Elestra. In fact, we identify this kind of the model defined in many, many European universities. Many people in Europe working in this kind of the model. The other possibility is when the people provide the information, the assessment using pairwise comparison. In this way, it's similar to the previous, but in this case, for every part of the alternative, we not only provide the binary value, we provide the specific membership degree, the specific degree, valued in the unit interval. This is the idea. Again, here, the comparison is very important. A very popular model that we identify in this class is the analytic hierarchy process provided by the professor Satis. Very popular. We have a lot of extension, fuzzy extension of this model. And finally, we identify the combination of the previous model. The people, many people combine the strengths of the multiple approach using the Goal programming. And now in the last year, very popular approach using this idea is the multimodal. And it's possible to identify, to find a lot of models using multimodal, a lot of application in the very, very important journals. In this decision-making framework, we identify two important challenges, two important trends that the people now is developing using the artificial intelligence and big data tools. In particular, the people are working in order to apply the natural language processing inside to the decision making. In this case, not to represent the linguistic level as similar to is possible to do with the fuzzy approach. The idea here is to work directly with the natural language processing in order to enrich the knowledge that you provide inside to the decision making model. Other additional idea that people is developing now is the idea to develop data-driven decision-making methodology to introduce additional information, for example, from the context inside to the model, okay? And to analyze this data and to provide more knowledge to decision-making. We identified different approaches in the last year in this direction. Okay, the second decision-making framework that we identified, the group decision-making, in this case, it's very popular now. It's possible. We developed in my research team a lot of different bibliometric studies about this topic. We identify a lot of different approaches. It's very popular now in our community. In the group decision making, we identify two processes to solve the problem: the consensus process. The goal of the processor concept is to get the maximum agreement degree among the expert opinion. Normally, in order to address this consensus process, you identify the specific consensus mission. It's possible to identify different ways to do that. And then when you achieve the consensus, the acceptable agreement degree among the expert opinion, you apply the selection process. The idea here is at the end to get the solution set of alternative from the consensus opinion. And even in this step, many people introduce different criteria in order to do that. Criteria based on dominant, non-dominant, there exists many papers about this topic. What is the more entrenched in group decision making? One important aspect is to model the social relation between the expert, the trust. Okay, this is possible to identify a lot of paper about to this topic now. Others to work in the large scale group decision making, in order to avoid the different manipulation process. For example, when you have a lot of people and other people want to control the opinion of the other expert. There is a lot of approach in order to introduce this control of the manipulation process. Other important idea is how to introduce in the group decision making the different tools in order to manage the opinion dynamics. In particular, when you are working social network. Social network, you have a lot of people that change quickly of the opinion, even the experts changing, the number of experts changing quickly, and how it's possible to manage this different problem. Other important topic that we identify is how it's possible to solve the conflict resolution among the experts in order to, at the end, to find the acceptable solution for all. Because in other case, it's possible to work, at the end, it's impossible to find the solution. Finally, in my research group, we are working in order to design personalized individual semantic in the linguistic context. Okay? The idea here is to design the particular personalized semantic for every people, because every people really identify or associate to the different level, different meaning. And we need to increase the freedom degree in this representation of the expert. This is our topic now. How is possible to define different semantic inside to the cell of the group of the expert? Finally, the first model is how is possible to combine the multiple person with multiple criteria. You had multiple person and multiple criteria, and you provide the opinion according to this framework. The trends in multi-criteria, multi-person decision-making framework is how it's possible to deal with the subjective criteria of the priority. The idea here is the same, how to apply inside to the process, decision process, more important, how to define acceptable weighting aggregating operator. Other important topic for me inside to this topic is how it's possible to introduce in the decision-making different psychological aspects in order to better understanding the expert behavior in order to understand the rationality. Sometimes in this case, we identify that in the different research group, the people introduce the collaboration with people, for example, from the psychology, because you need to understand the main of the people in order to introduce and to deal with this kind of the aspect. But it's necessary because at the end, the decision making is the emotional action, is the psychology action. And you make decision according to different variables, not only to the information that you provide, to the input, to the input that you receive from the other expert, but it's impossible to evaluate in the particular way. You need to know what is the rule that the people apply to make decision from the psychological point of view. Okay, now I want to share with you what is the challenges that we identify when you analyze this collection of the paper. I remember that we read around 300 paper in order to identify, to establish this taxonomy of the different approach that is possible to find the last 15 years. Okay, we identify, for example, that now we have different challenges in the definition of the consensus missions, okay? The idea here is how is possible, for example, to define practical consensus mission that is possible to apply not only in the example that the people provide in the literature. The idea is to apply in the real world. This is the challenge, important challenge now in order to continue in the research of the consensus process. Other challenge that I identify is the idea to design personalized feedback strategy, okay? Sometimes in the consensus process, we identify different way to do the feedback method, feedback strategy, but the idea here is normally the feedback method is general feedback method. The rules apply in the similar way for every aspect. The idea here is to identify the particular feedback method for every expert. Other interesting idea is how introduce in the consensus process the use of the gamification in order to close the approach, to help to the people to close the approach. This is a very interesting issue. The other important challenge that we identify is how it's possible to manage the opinion dynamic. Remember that the opinion dynamic is that in the particular way, in the particular framework, the people are dating the opinion of the interactive expert in the iterative-interactive process. How is possible to work with this kind of the situation, to avoid the problem of the fragmentation, to avoid the problem of the polarization of the opinion? This is the important challenge. here we identify the particular challenge in this management of the opinion dynamics. For example, how it's possible to establish the bridge, the gaps between opinion dynamic and group decision making. In this kind of the context, where appear a lot of people and change quickly, a lot of people with a lot of mentality, different mentality, is needed to characterize better the linguistic opinion. The more important topic, how is possible to design the strategy to avoid the manipulation of the opinion dynamics. This is different challenges that we identify in the management of the opinion dynamics, in particular in social network. Other important challenge that we identify is to define different decision-making models in the context of the social network analysis. Remember that the use of the social network analysis in decision-making focus on different use. For example, different use of the tasks, okay? For example, how is possible to develop the preference aggregation driven by truth relation? How is possible to estimate the incomplete preference relation using the trust relationship? More important is, for example, in the consensus process, how is possible to define the feedback method, the feedback recommendation using the trust relationship. But new challenges that is possible to establish in this topic is how is possible to identify the real trust relationship between the people. Sometimes in the social network, we identify the connection, direct connection between two persons, but sometimes more difficult to identify the connection with other people that participate in the process. They are connected by me or the other person, but not directly. How is possible to establish the real trust relationship in this topic? How is possible to introduce in the social network the idea of to model the dynamic from the different point of view? Okay. And more important, the last one, how is possible to avoid the problem of the dissonance behind in the social network, okay? The disinformation, the consequence of disinformation in the social network, in order to avoid, again, the manipulation is the more important problem. Other challenges we identify now that the people are working very hard is in the context of the large-scale decision-making. Firstly, it's necessary to define what is the concept of the large-scale, because it's more similar to the group decision making, but here the more important is the number of the people that are participating in the decision making process. The majority of the experts consider that we are working the large scale decision making when you had more than 20 participants in the main decision making, the group decision making. Okay, it's close to the social network, but we consider the limitation of the number of the people participating in the decision making process. In this context, the more important challenge that people are working now in the large scale decision making is the following. For example, when people spend the time in order to identify how it's possible to integrate the data and knowledge about the expert in the large scale decision making. Because when you have many people to make decisions, the complexity of the decision making process is high and you need additional information in order to find the solution. Other people propose to deal with this kind of the situation, the large-scale decision-making framework, the use of the analysis dashboard in order for monitoring the expert, the action, the performance, in order to understand better the decision-making situation. And this way to help to the people to make good decisions. Other people are working in order to apply the blockchain for distributed, safe, and transparent. Here the important is how to introduce different levels of security in the representation of the information or in the representation of the action, okay? One important aspect is the use of the different large-scale decision-making model in the context of the smart territory, using the Internet of the Thing. In this case, you receive the input of the content using the Internet of the Things. Even more important here is how it's possible to use the artificial intelligence, the machine learning tool, in order to provide more knowledge about to the expert content. This is very popular now. My feeling is that it's very important to study in this direction. How is possible to apply artificial intelligence in the content in order to enrich the decision-making process using the not only the information that the people provide, not only the information that you know about to the criteria, information around to the people, okay, in the context. And we have the possibility to do that using the different sensory system using the Internet of the Thing. Other important topic that we identify is the developer or the recommender system-based decision making. You know that the recommender system is very popular technology. It's the base of the many important companies, many important services that we know. For example, Amazon is the base, initial the base of the Amazon's recommender system. Now the idea is to apply this idea in the context of decision making. And we identify two fields. People working the group recommender system and people working multi-criterion recommender system is the two extensions of the traditional decision-making framework. The challenges of recommender system-based decision-making are the idea to design recommender system with the high number of the users. This is one important topic that the people are working now. Other idea is to introduce artificial intelligence in the recommender system using the data you had around. But in this context, in the context of the recommender system. Other important challenge that we had a lot of connection with the previous one is the idea to develop data-driven decision-making for a smarter decision AI. How many people spend the time in order to design different ideas to extract using information for the diverse data before I say you, not only the opinion that people provide, the content, the other idea, even the history of the decision-making situation. Other people are working the data-driven large-scale decision-making. Other people are working not only the possibility that the people provide the opinion. If you have a situation that is very difficult to provide the opinion, sometimes the people design, the people are working in order to develop machine learning to learn preference inside the decision process. It's a way to deal with the incomplete information sometimes. Here, the important challenge is how it's possible to integrate the data with the specific artificial intelligence technology in order to explore this information. Okay. Here, I want to say that you observe many, many different papers that we analyzed in the last 10 years are spending a lot of time in order to introduce different technologies to analyze the data, different technology of the machine learning to enrich the decision-making activity. Normally, this is not very popular in the previous one, but now, is the topic, how it's possible to combine different technology in order to enrich the decision-making context and to make good decisions for the future. In our words that you can see in the specific journal, at the end I share with you the reference, it's possible to identify many, many different opportunities, many different challenges that the people are studying now. In particular, we are working, many people are working now in order to design the real and practical case study in order to validate the real impact of the model. Because when you analyze many different papers, this collection of the paper, you said that the people use many different toy examples, toy models. But we need to translate the theoretical model to the real situation. We need to establish the different standard that the people want, the people can to compare the different models, in order to identify what is the strength and what is the drawbacks of this model to improve. But in our community, it's not very usual to do that, and we need to establish this kind of the collection of the example in order to compare the different alternatives, okay? The idea sometimes is to design, we identify other lines to design new large-scale social network with dynamic opinion. Other people focus in other challenges in order to detecting the influence opinion. The idea here is to analyze, to apply different measures that is possible to identify in the theory of the social networks analysis, but to introduce this measure in the context of the decision making, in order, for example, to identify the influencing expert, the people that control the decision and to enrich the activity. But previously, I said you, many people of our research group are working now in the definition of the complete linguistic decision making because, okay, normally the people provide the opinion, but only not only using the one linguistic level. People provide using a lot of different expressions and how it's possible to combine a lot of different expressions in the context of the group decision making or multi-criteria decision making or the combination, how it's possible to do that when you provide a lot of different linguistic expressions to provide the opinion. This is the more important challenge, in particular in our topic, of the design of the linguistic approach in decision making. More important, not only is necessary to establish the collection of the sample to compare, to validate the model, you need to define the appropriate measure in order to evaluate the performance of the decision making model. This is usual, this is traditional in other community, for example, in information retrieval. The people use two very important and popular measure in order to compare the information retrieval system. The precision and recall is very popular. Even it's possible to use both measure in other content, recommended system. But we need to establish here what is the measure that we need to define in order to evaluate the performance of decision making. We need to spend the time in order to analyze this issue. A collection of examples are a particular methodology in order to evaluate the performance of decision making. This is the challenge. We need to do that in order to improve for the future our proposal. My conclusion, when we finish the reading of this collection of the paper, we identified this kind of a challenge, this kind of a model. And my feeling was the following. In the literature, it's possible to find many fuzzy decision-making models, but in many cases, we observe that this model can be far from the reality in the representation of the assessment. From the theoretical point of view, it's good, but from the real point of view, they are far from the reality. And we need to close both the theoretical model with the reality model. This is important to do. Even in my presentation, I don't comment, but we identify many, many different representation formats that, in my opinion, are stupid sometimes. They don't provide any important information to the fuzzy decision-making model. The author play with the fuzzy decision extension, but they don't provide real element, real advantage to the fuzzy decision-making model that they provide. This is more important drawback. By this reason, we need that we must rethink, revisit, redirect, study, trying to be more realist. This is the necessity of our community. This is the critical aspect that we need to solve. Now we have the opportunity not only to work with our comfort framework, we need to extend the technology that we apply in decision-making system. For example, we have the possibility to apply the artificial intelligence tools in order to driving and to introduce the possibility to apply the digital transformation in our model and to contribute to the society with our model. For me, it's clear, we need to design the combination of the artificial intelligence with the decision theory in order to design models that form wise decision in the better ways. Artificial intelligence, which you know now, is very important for many topics. In my opinion, it's a way to enrich our decision traditional model using the artificial intelligence tools. Sometimes to discover new preference. Sometimes to discover new knowledge that is possible to use in the decision-making process in order to enrich. Sometimes to model new content that we had. Before I say you, the combination of the situation with the Sensi framework. And to do that, we need additional tools. And this is the opportunity, and we need to open the mind in order to introduce this kind of technology. Okay, we published the complex analysis of the situation of the fuzzy decision-making model at this moment in this paper, revisiting fuzzy and linguistic decision-making scenario and challenges for making wise decision in the best way. We developed this paper with my collaborator from Granada, the Professor Iván Palomares, Francisco Javier Carrizo, Paco Chiclana, Francisco Herrera, and other collaborators from China, Professor Yucheng Zhong and Kong Kong Li. And we published this paper recently in the year 2021 in the IEEE Transaction System and Cybernetic System. I recommend it to you to read. We provide in the paper more complete information about to this situation, about to the analysis of the fuzzy and linguistic decision making. But important here, we had a lot of way to improve our model, but we need to rethink our model, in particular using the artificial intelligence tools. Thank you for your attention, Amiro.
Thank you so much. So, do you have questions, comments? It's very stimulating work on decision making, state of art, and the challenge. Decision making is very important topics in computer science, and there are a lot of challenges, in fact, but it has some sort of lacking in terms of reality. And this reality gives it some sort of boundness and some sort of ways that still not applicable, well, in some way. And well, questions here, we have people, and some of the questions that I can provide you in the case, the quality of decision-making, even in theory, and how much really these techniques can provide trust in terms of the quality that the decision making is being achieved through these kind of methods. Do you have some?
No, you know, Hamido, that the people normally provide different trust issues in order to validate the model, but the idea normally is to compare with the previous model in the same example. But what happened? They use the same example, normally toy example. And this is my question. I did that before because I learned to do that in our community, but it's clear that we need to change to introduce additional methodology to validate a standard methodology, but not to only to compare with the previous, okay? We need to define this collection of the sample, that all people use this collection of the sample to show the utility, the usefulness of his or their model. And then we need to define a collection of the issue to validate the performance. In our community, nobody do that. Nobody think to that. You know that.
Yeah.
But we need to overcome this problem.
Well, you put, Enrique, the title of this paper, for example, Wiser Decision, Wise. And, you know, wise is some sort of come from wisdom, some sort of knowledge. And most of the decision making so far, all the approach doesn't provide this kind of properties in terms of wisdom or knowledge. So that's, you think, AI, artificial intelligence, can provide this gap? Do you think so?
Yes, I think that this is the idea, Hamido. Now we need to use this idea to enrich the decision-making, and more important, to define the real decision-making model in the real context. And in the real context, you know, you don't have only the expert opinion. You have additional source.
Yeah.
Sometimes at this moment you had a lot of data. You need to use different technology to say what is the best day, what is the data you need, and what is the way to discover information inside to this day. Okay, it's clear. Now you need to join both fields, decision theory with the real problem. But a way to do that is to apply artificial intelligence. I just said that I say you in many the last paper that we analyze and our community that the people decide to do that, to introduce different way to apply artificial intelligence. For example, when the people provide the opinion in the real in the social network, it's possible to extract the more important information from the this community using the different sensitivity analysis, using artificial intelligence, okay? Sentiment analysis. This is a way to apply the artificial intelligence. Even the idea to process the, to introduce the use of the natural language processing in the decision making activity is a way to apply artificial intelligence, because to process a natural language, you need to apply artificial intelligence tools. And this is the way that we need to follow at this moment, in my opinion. It's more difficult, but it's necessary.
Yeah, but you can see in decision making, for example, to conclude, for example, we do decision making every day.
Yes. And
even for when you drive a car, also you do decision making to find the best way to go through the traffic. So you see this kind of criteria and the evaluation of the criteria in terms of the theory that so far provided by Fuzzy Set Whenever, I don't think since 1970s, you know, 1970, when Lutfi Zadeh provided this kind of theory, we have already about 50 years of history of fuzzy system. But we didn't see much in reality that being brought to practice. So what do you think the main problem here?
The main problem is that we need to extend our idea not only to use fuzzy system, we need to combine with other kind of information, Hamid.
Okay.
The fuzzy system is good to manage the uncertainty, but not to manage it all. Okay.
Yeah.
We need to combine with others, it's clear.
Don't you think that adding machine learning aspect on decision making can make it better?
Well, I think that it's possible to improve the decision making. For example, to manage the incomplete preference before I say you, it's possible to apply artificial intelligence to learn new preference without to use the input of the expert sometimes. Yes. Yeah. In fact, this is the more important aspect of the artificial intelligence tools, the possibility to discover information in the cloud of the day. This is opportunity to do that.
Is there any question? Yes, please. We have a question from the audience.
Hi, probably it's a little bit more than...
we can check.
Yeah, okay. So it's probably better. Probably it's a little bit more a remark or than a question. What I have noticed in the last, I don't know, 10 years roundabout, is that in a lot of disciplines, we are moving from checking something, proving stuff, to trusting things, especially in security. So the problem is that we cannot measure security because we do not have the information to have an idea how secure a system is because it's too complex. So the solution somehow is that we move this to trust. So when we get to a state where we trust a system or operator or whatever, then we are willing to use it. And for me, this is somehow a complicated movement because you are not proving stuff, you are just trusting stuff. And for me, this is very dangerous. You have this example with AI, especially with self-driving cars. You cannot really prove that this system is secure or safe or whatever. So you start to trust it. But in reality, this means you have no clue whether the system will behave in the correct way the next time or not. So the question is, do you have any answer to this? Can you get back to proving stuff or is this done?
Your question is very interesting, very reality from the real point of view. But it's, what you say is very complicated. And we need to focus this problem from the different point of view. How to manage the trust inside to the system, but even this question that you say me is related to design the ethical rules, the trust rules. That the people who are implementing different applications of artificial intelligence use these rules in order to avoid, in order to transmit to the people that it's possible to trust in the decision. It's not only the problem that you question me is not only the problem to apply the artificial intelligence, it's necessary to design the trust framework around to the application, because in other case, the people decide don't use the decision that provide the system because they don't trust in the system. And we need to establish this framework. Before, at the beginning, I comment with Hamidu that we are working now in Granada in order to define the specific office to establish the rules, the idea to control and to supervise the application of artificial intelligence in the different topics. In order to give to the user the trust on the decision that is possible to extract of this application. This is necessary, and this is the challenge for the humanity today. Even you know that there is a a very important discussion about this topic in USA, in Asia, and Europe. But in Europe is very important because the people like to receive the opinion, but the people had a lot of questions about to the different manipulation form that the company do in order to introduce the bias in the decision. This is good opportunity, but in all the problem to apply the artificial intelligence in the model, we need to design the external agent to control, to establish the standard, to develop the application of artificial intelligence in the different topics. We need to study that. And now in Granada, we are working in this direction with our Spanish government in order to establish this standard. But I agree with you. We need to establish this trust framework in order to transmit to the people the corresponding trust in the decision that they receive from the system. I have no answer about that. Thank you.
It's not so easy, but thank you very much.
But it's necessary to work this direction. Camilo.
One question, Enrique.
Okay, the last one, because I need to go.
So I think only one. I'm sorry.
Muchas gracias por la presentación, muy interesante, pero concisa. So my question is, we have just touched the aspect of improving decision making with artificial intelligence models, but I want to ask something completely the opposite. Whether there is a good way to contribute to artificial intelligence explainability with the use of better decision making. So do you see the way that decision making can help to create explainable artificial intelligence?
the opposite. Yes. This is other line that you propose is very interesting, okay? Not to use the artificial idea for decision apply to decision making to explain the decision that you extract. This is opposite. Interesting to study this case. I don't identify any paper about this topic, but it's necessary to do that in order to create this trust framework that the previous people asked me. You need to provide tools to explain appropriately what is the way that the algorithm apply in order to make the decision. This is necessary. This is other important challenge that the people are working now. In this case, I never think about that, but I agree with you that it's possible to apply different decision-making tools to design the explicability method for artificial intelligence. It's interesting way.
Just an idea.
Thank you.
Enrique, thank you so much. So appreciate it. This is the time, so you have a meeting, and we'll keep in touch.
I meet you, but I had to meet you here in December, okay?
Yes, of course. So, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
A kiss.
Bye.
Thank you, bye-bye. You Superman, always a Superman, my friend. So we have a good people attending. I think the session, we start the session now. Who's the session chair for?